Now let's get into this next prompting framework. So this is called I want you to act as prompting. So this framework is another way to really give a universally applicable input to ChatGPT. So let's check out our prompting formula. So I want you to act as dot, dot, dot. It could be a historian, a biologist, anything that helps set the stage for ChatGPT's persona. I will give you my target audience, a specific direction, a product. This is really where we set up the dynamic between you and ChatGPT. You will then, it could be create emails, make a video script, or summarize a specific piece of text. And I want you to do that in the tone and style of XYZ. It could be more upbeat, professional, or even tabular format. So this is where we want to explain the desired output and the writing style. Next is the important details. So if you're asking in point two, I want you to give my target audience a specific direction, you have to then also elaborate on what those things are. So if you say you're going to give ChatGPT your target audience, in bullet point five, you want to explain who your target audience is so that the output can be as effective as possible. And then number six, we want to refine the output as needed. So once we get our output, we could then ask ChatGPT to be more persuasive, put the important keywords in bold, or put it in a different format. So we have two examples at the bottom. The first is setting up the persona as a personal coach and saying, okay, I'm going to give you my personal professional goals. I want you to create a 7-day schedule in order for me to hit those goals. My short-term goals are this, my long-term goals are that, and to please put your answer in tabular format. The next example, which is what I want to walk through with you, is I want you to act as a virtual doctor. I'll describe my symptoms and you will provide a diagnosis and treatment plan. You should only reply with your explanation, diagnosis, and treatment plan and nothing else. My important details are I've been experiencing headache and dizziness for the last few days. What could be the cause? So we'll go ahead and put that in the ChatGPT and you can start to see how putting ChatGPT in a different persona opens up the field that, let's say you're traveling and you don't have access to your doctor that you would normally speak with. This is something where you can get a personalized diagnosis from a quote unquote medical professional. You can do the same exact thing with this framework, but use it as a personal coach, a financial advisor, or anything that you could really think up using this framework. So let's see what our answer is from ChatGPT. We have our explanation, we have our diagnosis, we have our treatment plan. So we can ask ChatGPT to elaborate on this further. Of course, with something like medical advice or financial advice, you want to speak to a real professional, but the important part here is the framework. Asking ChatGPT to act as a persona, telling them what you're going to provide them and what you expect is a major fundamental of prompt engineering and is going to help you progress as you go through this course to create better inputs and in turn create more effective outputs.